This is the Megmeet Indoor Inverter Board, used in many mini-split air conditioner brands. And today I will provide you with full information about it. First, you can see that the main supply is connected to this relay. Check the supply on its connector. If there is any voltage issue, fix it right there. After that, the blue wire is for neutral and the brown wire is for phase. They are directly connected to the fuse. If this fuse is faulty, the unit will not function properly and this will cause problems. Therefore, it's important to check the fuse. If it is blown, replace it. There's a chance that your PCB will start working fine. Next, you can see there is a PTC sensor here. Its job is that if the voltage becomes too high and if there is any problem inside the PCB, it will increase its resistance and heat up, which will prevent voltage from passing through, and no further issues will occur. Then there's a capacitor here, which is installed to absorb any kind of spikes. After that, line filter is installed to filter further electrical noise. After this, there is a ZNR. The purpose of the ZNR is that whenever high voltage occurs, the ZNR will short, and this will cause the fuse to blow, saving the rest of the PCB. If you set your multimeter to continuity or ohms mode, and it shows a short or some resistance, then it means the ZNR is faulty, and you need to replace it. This will increase the chances that your unit will start working again. Now, let's talk about the rectification process. Look at the diodes, two on the left side and two on the right side. The points of both are connected together here at BD3 and BD4, while BD1 and BD2 are connected separately. You should get 220 to 230 volts on the upper side, and on the lower side, you should get 320 volts on BD4 and BD2. As soon as rectification occurs and the AC is converted to DC, this capacitor removes ripples and smooths the voltage. So instead of 220 or 230 volts, you should get 310 or 320 volts here. Now let me tell you one more thing. This capacitor here labeled EC1, if it is short-circuited, the PCB will not work. But there's one more important thing I need to explain. This capacitor has a capacity of around 500 volts. If you replace it with a 400 volt or 450 volt capacitor, it will not work and will likely explode within a nanosecond. That's why, when replacing it, you need to make sure to install a 500 volt capacitor, and its capacity should be 22 microfarads. Now let me explain to you that instead of a switching IC, a MOSFET, and a current mode PWM controller has been installed here. Now, the reason for using it this way is that if any system were to use a switching IC, it would work better. The reason for this is that if the capacitor is 500 volts, it will work. Otherwise, it will blast. This has been done to ensure stability so that the entire SMPS system remains stable and doesn't get damaged repeatedly. The MOSFET has been installed here for this purpose, and its job is to turn on the chopper. When the chopper turns on, it performs DC to DC conversion, generating voltage. Now, let me tell you where and what the voltage should be. This is the current mode PWM controller IC. Its job is to keep the SMPS turned on and stable. If it doesn't work, the entire SMPS circuit will not function. Inside it, there is also a timer, which turns on and then searches for feedback. Here, you can see an optocoupler, HP1, which generates feedback. When low voltages are generated from the DC to DC transformer, these low voltages are sent towards the microcontroller. In this way, the generated low voltages need to be communicated to the PWM controller IC so that it can stabilize the SMPS. For this purpose, a separate circuit is designed, allowing feedback to reach the PWM controller IC through this optocoupler. Now here, look at capacitor C4. It should give us 16 or 15 volts. Similarly, if you look at capacitor C5, we should also get 16 or 15 volts on it. If both capacitors show 16 or 15 volts, it means the SMPS is functioning correctly. However, if the system still doesn't turn on, check the resistance RJ2. If it is damaged for any reason, the system and SMPS will not work. Therefore, it is necessary to check it. If it is short-circuited or burnt, replace it. There are chances that the system will start working again. Additionally, if the PWMIC itself is damaged, the SMPS will not work. So these components need to be checked. The PWMIC receives feedback and stabilizes the MOSFET. Due to this stabilization, the chopper turns on, and as the chopper turns on, the DC to DC converter on the other side produces DC voltage. I will explain further where the other voltages should be in the second part of this video. See you in the second part of the video. Click on the left or right thumbnail to watch our next videos, and subscribe. Thank you.